he'll be sitting in Collin County, Rockwall County, and Kaufman County once a month. And veterans who are suffering from traumatic brain injuries or PTSD or any other kind of mental illness or drug addiction will be served in our county. We're one of the smallest counties in the state to have both a DWI and a drug and mental health court. Now we're adding additional services for our vets through the Veterans Court. We have an assistant DA by the name of Phil Williams, who's a West Pointer, and he's going to be assigned to that court. And Judge Roach is a veteran himself, and he'll be coming down once a month to preside. And the drug court team and the veterans court team, made up of the sheriff's office, probation office, mental health service treatment providers, the judge's office, and I think I've covered everyone. Casey, did I leave anyone out?
No, sir.
But it's going to be a great service to the people of this community. We are continuing to expand. You know, once you get a little experience on the bench, you see all kinds of potential opportunities to expand services and do good things for the people of our county. I got involved in the Drug and Mental Health Court program because it became so apparent to me, after sitting on the bench for a couple of years, that so many people caught up in the criminal justice system have mental health issues and drug abuse issues. They don't really need to be locked up. They need to be treated. And if they're non-predatory, non-violent people, if you treat them, get them the services they need, keep them sober, get them back in the community, get them jobs, get them reunited with their families, they can thrive and become productive members of our community again. We have had 47 people graduate from our program since 2010. Of those 47, we have a 12% recidivism rate. That means only 12% have reoffended and relapsed. That is almost unbelievable with that population. Most of my people are co-occurring disorders, which means they not only are mentally ill, they also are drug addicts. And so it's a very difficult population to treat. We have been very successful treating them. And it is one of those great services, you know, that if you could keep people out of the penitentiary costing $100 a day for these special needs inmates, save the taxpayers those dollars and save those lives at the same time. It's a win-win for everyone. So it's been a great pleasure to run that program. Does anyone else have any questions? If not,